Just as we can use operators to manipulate numbers, there are also a set of operators we can use to manipulate strings. And in addition to these operators, there's something else called functions we can use as well. So in this video, we're going to take a look at a couple of different string operators and string functions. These are all about somehow working with strings in one way or another. On the screen right now, I've got a partial list of one ARP operator. So this is an operator we can use to join two strings, and several different functions we can use as well. We have not looked at functions in SQL just yet, but these functions work very similar to how functions work in many other programming languages. Let's take a look at an example of how we would join two strings using either this pipe operator or the concat function. Okay, so back over at pg-sql.com, I'm going to try to select the name and country of every city, and I'm going to join them or concatenate them together by using that pipe operator. So we would write out select name and then pipe pipe. Now those are not L's, they are not I's, they are the character that is to the right, just top of the return key on your keyboard. So I'll put in that symbol twice, and then country from cities, like so. I'm going to run that, and then we'll see that we get back a result of Tokyo, Japan, Delhi, India, and so on. Now, we probably don't want to just take the name and country and just join them directly together, because the result is kind of hard to read. So we might want to put an extra little comma in there, and maybe a space as well. So something that says Tokyo, comma, Japan, just to make this a little bit easier to read. So to do so, we can concat with string constants as well. Right after the first double pipe, I'm going to put in a set of single quotes. Then inside there, I'll put in a comma and then a space. On the other side of the single quote, I'm going to put in another double pipe. So this can be interpreted as give me the name, then give me a comma and a space, and then the country. Let's try running this. All right, that's a little bit more legible. Now, just as we saw with some of those different other operators for mathematical operations, SQL is renaming, or Postgres is renaming this column to question mark, column, question mark. So we might want to put in another as keyword here to manually rename this generated column so it's more clear what this column is all about. So I might put in an as location. Now, if I run this again, I get a much better little column name there. That's a little bit more clear about what is going on with this data. All right, so that is an example of an operator. We can use a function called concat to also join two strings. So this pipe operator and the concat function do the exact same thing. It is simply the syntax we are using that makes the difference. Let's try doing the exact same operation using concat. I'm going to delete name all the way to the end of country. I'll then replace it with all capitals concat. I'm going to call it as though it were a function, just like we would call functions in many different programming languages. And then inside of here, I'm going to add in a couple of different arguments. So the arguments I put into this function are going to be the different strings that I want to join together. So I want to try to take the name of every row, and I want to join it with the country of every row. I'll put in name, comma, country. I'll then run that, and we get the same operation or the same result that we had before. So it definitely works equivalent to that pipe operator. Again, the syntax is just a little bit different. Let's try adding in that extra little comma and space once again to just get a little bit more separation between the city and the country. So right after name, I've got the comma right there. I'll then put in a empty string with single quotes. I'll put a comma inside there and a space right after. And then outside of the single quote, I'll put another comma. So the syntax, again, kind of hard to read, but we're essentially saying take the name, take a comma and a space, and the country, and join those three strings together. So I'm going to run this again, and I get the same result I had before. All right. We could also make use of other functions for manipulating strings, such as lower or upper. That will give us the lowercase or the uppercase value of some column. Let's try turning the name and country right here into uppercase and then joining them together. We can stack together as many functions as we want. So rather than deleting anything here, let's try to wrap name right here with a uppercase function call. So right in front of name, I'm going to put in upper and then close off the parentheses on the other side. And I'll do the same thing over here for country as well. You'll notice now that my query is rather long, I'm going to click the Format button at the very top to automatically format this query, just to make it a little bit easier to read. Now if we run this, we get everything in all capitals. We could, of course, instead of putting upper in front of name and country, we could try to get the uppercase version of what comes out of the concat function. So for example, if I undo the changes that we just made, so I'm going to take out the upper right there, I'm going to take out the country upper right there as well, and then I will wrap the entire concat statement with an upper function call. I'll make sure I get an opening parenthesis right there, and then a closing parenthesis on the very other side. I'll then run that, and I get the exact same result. Okay, lower is going to work very similar. It's going to give you the lowercase version of a string, and the length function is going to give you, as the note says right there, it's going to tell you the number of characters in a string. Length might be one of the more useful functions that you're going to make use of if you ever want to find strings of a particular length. We'll see some examples of that later on. All right, so we've taken a look at another operator. In this case, it is a string operator. We've also introduced the idea of functions as well. Let's continue on in just a moment.